I remember just a couple of years ago, you know, like 5 or 10, people were avoiding the fats like crazy. They were cutting the fat off the meat before eating, using little or no oil, and eating lots of nuts was considered nuts. Today, Atkins, keto, and paleo diets are on the rise. Eating high fat, low carb is super trendy. But how come? Can we really lose weight by eating according to this diet? And if we can, how healthy can that be? Well, depends on who you ask. The thing is that low-carb diets are pretty new and not a lot of research has been done. So we're gonna take a look at what we know so far. What is a high-fat diet? Like you can imagine, it means eating a lot of fats, a small amount of carbohydrates, and a moderate amount of protein. So little or no pasta, rice, potatoes, cookies or bread, and a lot of fish, meat, yogurt, and vegetables. No pasta. That would kill me. The ketogenic diet in medicine is a diet that is used to treat hard-to-control epilepsy by forcing the body to burn fat rather than carbohydrates. This is where the high-fat, low-carb diet originates from and what the main idea behind it is. Force your body to burn fats instead of carbs. You might know this diet by some other name, Atkins, keto, or paleo diet. Different name, same principle. This kind of eating became trendy thanks to many celebrities, such as Mick Jagger, Rihanna, Alec Baldwin, Matthew McConaughey, LeBron James, or Halle Berry. Why? Because this diet helped them and many others to lose weight faster, to stay in better shape, and to improve their overall health. Is it true though? Yes, studies have shown that people on a low-carb diet lose more weight compared to low-fat diet. But sadly, only initially. Over time, however, this advantage diminishes and is overall insignificant. Damn it! Why? Because this diet is very restrictive, so it's very hard to keep eating like that and keep an active social life. Party! Compared to the Mediterranean and the low-fat diet, people on a high-fat diet have the highest incidence of lapses and dropouts 2 years after they started the diet. And so, like all diets, as soon as you start eating normally and party all night long, well, the weight will come back. Because, you know, when it comes to diet, there is no secret behind it. You have to burn more calories than you eat. And the more we see it and eat, well, it shows. Now, is this diet at least healthy? Well, depends on who you ask. And mostly it's pretty new, so not enough research has been done to prove the benefits or threats to our health. However, here's what we know so far for sure. Carefully planned high-fat, low-carb diet can be healthy and can help us lose weight. But before you get excited, consider that there are some side effects, such as constipation, headache, bad breath, low energy levels, brain fog, increased hunger, and sleep problems. But here's more. The advocates of this diet claim that on this diet your cholesterol levels will drop, which is true and it's not true. Yes, the HDL cholesterol drops, but instead the LDL cholesterol rises, which puts us in risk of developing clogged arteries. So, not the best. Now, let's talk about diabetes, shall we? Although high carbohydrate intake is not linked to the risk of onset of type 2 diabetes, some evidence shows that a diet rich in certain high-carb items like high sugar drinks or white rice can increase the risk. And if we have type 2 diabetes, this kind of diet can help us lose weight and help us with our glycemic control. However, same is not true for managing type 1 diabetes. According to the American Diabetes Association and European Association for the Study of Diabetes, the Mediterranean diet is better at improving the glycemic control compared to high-fat, low-carb diet. And that even if healthy weight is very important for diabetics, there is no single ratio of carbohydrate, protein, and fat intake that is optimal for every person with type 2 diabetes. Because even in diabetes, we are all individual and special. A new study published in December 2018 in the American Journal of Physiology, Heart and Circulatory Physiology claims that high-fat diet is bad for both younger males and females, but might be more dangerous for females. The study was done on rats and suggests that high-fat diet affects both genders, specifically their blood sugar, which increases. But since we are not rats, let's wait for some further research, shall we? The biggest issue with high-fat diet is that in rare cases, some people can experience ketoacidosis. That is a serious metabolic issue which usually only happens because of diabetes, alcoholism, or starvation, and requires immediate medical attention. Yeah, because I need my pasta. Another problem is that significant restriction of carbohydrate intake risks causing malnutrition and can make it difficult for us to get enough dietary fiber to stay healthy. And lastly, since we're talking about diet and weight loss, high-quality research shows no long-term weight loss advantage of high-fat diet over a low-fat one. No matter how much we want a quick fix, developing healthy eating habits is the best way to keep the weight off and keep living healthy for a long time. And talking about quick fix, don't forget to subscribe to not miss our next video. Tell us in the comments what do you think about this topic and share your personal experience with this diet if you have any. Like the video and share it so more people can enjoy in our content, and see you in the next one. Bye bye!